So this is a small module on how to bracket teeth properly. And this presentation was actually designed under my guidance, Dr. Jean-Marc Trouvé, but done by Dr. Fong and Dr. Ritt from McGill University. So precise bracket placement is the most important aspect in orthodontics after correct diagnosis and written planning procedures, as seen right here. That's a pure straight wire system. So as you can see, we use pre-adjusted brackets. We have torque and tip built into their bases. And it's very important for them, if you want to have a good alignment, to be properly positioned on teeth. And if you do this and you position your brackets at the optimum position on the crown of the teeth, well, usually the treatment duration will be shorter. So what are the general steps in bracket bonding? The objective of this presentation is to show you basically how a step-by-step bracketing technique will be illustrated with text and videos. In this case, it's a video. So first thing you want to do, you have to prophy the crown of the teeth, especially the labial aspect of the tooth, with a pumice. And then you use a composite system. There are many on the market. This happens to be Reliance, which I like. There, again, it's not the only one. And I use UltraDent blue blue etching gel. I don't use anymore the liquid because I think the gel is better visible on the teeth. Doesn't mean that the liquid is bad, but this is a bit more convenient. So first of all, very important, you isolate your teeth with cheek retractors like so, and make sure the patient is fairly comfortable. And you etch, okay? So you have to etch with 35% acid for 15 seconds, and then you remove the excess with water. It's important, again, the advantage of using the gel is that you can really position the gel pretty much where you want the bracket to be. You avoid the mesial or distal embrasures, you avoid the gingiva, and you don't etch unnecessary tooth structure. Then you rinse for 15 seconds with a high speed suction and high volume suction, I should say, and some air water syringe. You dry the field, and you have to see a chalky white appearance. If you don't have this, probably the prophylaxis was not efficient. In cases of composite resins, you have to, before you do any etching, you have to roughen up the etch, or the composite, I should say, to ensure that the new bonding from the composite system will let the bracket bond to the old composite. And then you apply your light coat of resin. So it's a very thin coat of resin, and you light cure for 20 seconds. You use basically a Landmark composite instrument. You can use what you want, but this one works really well. And make sure that you're going to press the bracket firmly in order to minimize resin excess. That's one problem. Sometimes the bracket is not completely in intimate contact with the crown of the tooth, and that may cause problems in tooth alignment in the future. So again, you have a very light coat of resin. You cure it for 10 seconds. Make sure you select the proper bracket. Happens once in a while that your system doesn't place the bracket in its right slot. So always verify that the slot is distal gingival. This happens to be a canine bracket. Like in here, it's a different canine bracket from a different brand, but the slot is distal gingival, and you have to bracket the teeth as well as possible. So now you isolate these tooth from the other ones, the crown, I should say, and you position immediately, you place the bracket in as best a position as you can. Then you have to measure the height from the incisor edge, and you have to center the bracket distal mesially, and make ensure that the incisor edge of the bracket right here is parallel to the incisor edge of the tooth. You see there are variations in anatomy. As you can see, this tooth right here, this central incisor, is different from this one. So there'll be some slight modification when you bracket this tooth to make sure that you are going to get the proper gingival level with the same incisal margin. So there may be some differences in these two bracket placements right on the same patient. Same thing, avoid parallax problems. You have to look at the brackets and the teeth from the correct angles. So with this very rough drawing, what I want to show you is when you bracket the upper teeth, you have to be almost at the level of these teeth. So the patient has actually to be in a supine position. So you can see the crown of the teeth in a very perpendicular way. You don't want to go from too high or too low because you may end up having the bracket misplaced in the incisal gingival position, or the worst one is actually looking from the side and then you end up with a bracket that is off center from the tooth. So we usually use a mirror to make sure that you see the whole incisal edge of the tooth and you have a good idea of how the bracket is positioned in its center compared to the mesial or the distal aspect of the tooth. So you have to use the mirror to check the long axis of the tooth. Try always to set your bracket in the proper position regarding the long axis of the tooth. Obviously, when you press the bracket onto the tooth, you will have some excess of composite, and then you have to clean it. It doesn't change much the orthodontic treatment, but it helps the patient with his dental hygiene, and obviously makes the looks of the orthodontic implants much nicer and neater. So remove the excess, as I just said. And then it's time to measure the height. So you've positioned, as you see, we put two brackets already. And again, this one looks a bit different from this one because of the tooth anatomy. Now you are going to measure using a boom gauge the height of the bracket. As an example, the upper incisor is 4 millimeters from the incisal edge. The lateral incisor is 3.5. And depending on different area of the mouth, well, the bracket placement gauge will be used differently. So it's a bit much easier to use in the anterior area, and it's much more difficult in the premolar area. As you can see here on the dental form, it's pretty easy to get your bracket placement gauge parallel to the occlusal plane because there was no lips, and it's fairly easy for the gauge to be positioned into the brackets. On a real patient, it requires a bit more work. So you keep on bracketing. You make sure that your brackets are well positioned. Don't forget to use the curing light between each bracket. And it's very important to position the incisal edges, incisal edges, all the marginal ridges at the right place. So the best way to do it is to get the bracket into the proper level on the occlusal plane. So depending on what you do, as we can see in this patient, the teeth are pretty much, this tooth is in crossbite, this tooth is too high, so the gingival margins are a little bit different, the left side is a bit better, but there is not too much wear on the incisal edges. So what you want to do is position the brackets so when there is an alignment, the incisal edges will be well positioned and you will have also nice gingival margins that will respect the tooth anatomy. So if the incisal edges are not worn out, you may want to use the height gauge to position the bracket properly. If the incisal edge is worn out, then you have to use the gingival margins to place the bracket. So as you can see here, we have the same patient has had a straight wire system used with self-ligating brackets, and now you can see that the incisal edges are well defined and the lateral incisor is slightly higher than the central incisor. The two central incisors are the same level. The canines are slightly lower and the gingival margin is well scalloped and it makes a pretty aesthetic smile. How do we do that? Well, we use the average bracket placement tools. This one happens to be from the speed appliance system. We use a Roth prescription in this case. You can use pretty much what you want, but it's nice. And in this one, I like the setup because it gives you the torque values of each bracket. Again, matter of preference, you don't have to use these torques, but it gives you the height. In Dr. Anson's case, he liked to have the four incisors at the same level. In my case, I use 3.5, but it gives you a nice idea of how which height to bracket teeth when you have an average crown height. Thank you.